What's up, guys? I just got this new smart wall outlet from OITTM, and I just bought it on Amazon. It came in. It works with Alexa, so we're gonna give it a shot, try it out, check it out from the insides, you know, and plug it in and see if it works. So this plug is rated at 16 amps to 20 amps max. It's a 2000 watt maximum, so you can plug in pretty powerful devices, except you don't want to plug in a motor or anything like that, anything industrial. The Wi-Fi frequencies it works with is 2.4 gigahertz and A, B, G, and N, I believe. And yeah, pretty cool device. It comes in a white standard color. It's a glossy finish in the front. I do wish it came in different colors, like an almond color or something to match my outlets, but it's okay. There's also a button on top. We push that for on and off. It comes with a wall plate and two screws. It also comes with two extra longer screws to plug in your actual outlet in the wall socket. Here's your manual that it comes with. It shows you where everything needs to go. Everything is indicator, the on and off screws, the different poles for positive, negative, and ground. Now, in the later parts of this video, I will be showing you how I am hooking up my smart plug using the ground and hot and the negative wires. You also have to download the Smart Life app by Tuya Technologies, I think, and it's on the Amazon skill store, Alexa skill store, and it's free skill, and all you have to do is log in with your account you created in the app, and you set it up first in your app, the OTIM app, and then you go to your Amazon Alexa, sign in with that same account that you did in the app, and link the accounts by enabling it. And after you do that, you tell Alexa to discover devices, and it finds your device, the device name. So, and the device name is also changeable, which is pretty neat. So I could rename this wall outlet to lamp, or telephone, or whatnot, anything pretty much. And then all you have to do is tell Amazon Alexa to discover devices, and then it'll start to find that new named device. So once you remove the plug like that, you'll find this side, where this side is that's the hot side right there. The black wire is the hot. Now, if you're not safe, you don't feel safe doing this, call an electrician. That's the best way to do it. Call an electrician and they will replace the plug for you. But this is how I did it. I took it out, put them really far apart so they don't touch her. And before you mess with all this, I think, I mean, in my case, I turned off the breaker just to be safe. So there's no power in there, no live power. Then the other side, I'm gonna remove the white wire, which is the white is negative. And then your green is your ground. Now you will need a nose plier to straighten out the tips right there for each wire and make it straight so that you can clip it a little bit shorter so it fits inside the plug, the socket. So I'm gonna fast forward in here and I'll show you exactly how I did it. So here I'm clipping the end pieces to make it a little bit shorter. Then you want to unscrew that, those screws in your back of your wall socket right there. And then you want to fish in those wires directly into there. My negative is going into the negative side. Then the ground is going in. And then my hot wire will be put into the last part. I made sure that no extra wires no extra wire was hanging out. So I did actually went back and push it in even further and cut a little bit more if I needed to. So then you want to push back the thing, then get the two screws that are inside the packaging and use those and pop those both of the screws in and screw them in. Then you want to put the top screw in, screw it in all the way, bottom one, do the same, line it up straight, then put the wall plate on the top screw that came with it, then the bottom screw. But with these screws, you want to make sure that you don't slip the screwdriver in accident or else the paint will come off the screw. Then it'll blink like this, and that means that you're ready to go in the app. Download the app in the App Store, open it up, click on the smart plug, and put your Wi-Fi information, and then connect it. And it'll take some time to connect. Sometimes it's faster, sometimes it's slower. You just have to do this once. And mine connected pretty early. And it'll show a screen Alexa, like this after you connect it in the app.
Lamp.
Then you can rename it from smart socket to lamp or whatever you want to.
Alexa,
rename it to.
Turn off lamp.
In my case, I just put it to lamp. I plugged it in. And there we have it, testing it out. It shows you the electrical usage, the wattage, the voltage. It's pretty neat in the app. So you can monitor your electricity. You can create a timer. Now what I really need with this app, it doesn't have, where you can tell Alexa, turn on the lamp for 30 minutes. For 1 hour, 15 minutes. It needs that feature. So please, OITTM, add that feature in the Alexa skill. Alexa, start timer for 5 minutes, for 30 minutes, for 1 hour, something like that. And simple. Also, there's a switch. The button
Alexa,
on the left in that app,
turn on lamp.
There's also a switch, so it turns on and off. You can use a big old round button like I did to turn it on and off.
Or Alexa,
use your voice,
turn off
like
lamp.
I'm doing. So, it's a pretty neat device.
Alexa, turn off lamp.
It works well.
Alexa, turn on lamp.
And it also works with Google Home. So if you don't have Alexa, it'll work with Google Home. If you want to physically press a button to turn it on and off, you can press that button right there to
turn
it on and off.
Okay.
Alexa, turn off lamp.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on lamp for 30 seconds.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on lamp for
overall,
one
I think
hour.
It just needs fine tweaking and a little bit more
Alexa, turn off lamp.
Commands for Alexa. Like, Alexa, start the timer on my lamp or turn on lamp for 30 minutes or something like that. It needs that feature for sure, so please add that in the future. Other than this, it works well. And I'll see y'all in the next video. Thanks for watching.